This week, we want you to find a book, book chapter, or ebook for your assignment. We define a book as a print publication with its own title that is 50 pages or longer. I like this definition because it does identify a book as being longer than 50 pages, which can be helpful for students, so you know and understand that an article which only has 4 to 5 pages will not qualify as a book. This video is designed to help you know where you can go on the ISU Libraries website to search for a book. In past semesters, some students have had difficulty distinguishing between different types of sources. Some databases include a mix of books, journal articles, magazine articles, newspaper articles, and other types of sources. We will give examples so you can know what to look for to find a book. On the library homepage, you can see the OneSearch tab here on the left. When we search in this database, we can find scholarly articles as well as popular ones, plus we can find books. We will show you how you can use this database to find a book. If our topic has to do with the global population of the world and conflicts arising from competition for resources, we could enter the words global population and resources and conflicts. We can see that more than 1.6 million results come back to us. Use the limiters on the left side of the screen and select Catalog Only to find just the books. Another way to find a book is directly from the library catalog. On the library website, it is the second tab from the left. Because books are often on broad topics, it may be necessary to use fewer keywords in the search. I want to demonstrate a keyword Boolean search with just three main concepts: population and global or world and resources. This search brings back 114 titles. If I go back to the advanced search, then I can limit by date. Down here on the left, you can see that I can enter the dates 2009 and 2019. Then only books published within that time frame will come back in the search. Now we can see that the newest books appear at the top of the list, while the oldest books appear at the end. After taking a look at the results, we can see some of these titles look relevant, while other results do not. Results number 2, 7, and 9 look to be the most relevant. When we open the record for item number 9, we can see the table of contents, which shows the chapter titles in this book. We can see that there is a chapter that appears quite relevant: Human Population, Prosperity Growth, When I Fear, When I Don't, by Lawrence C. Smith. For your assignment, you are not required to read an entire book, but we do expect you to read a little bit from the book, and that might include reading the chapter that is the most relevant. A look at item number 2 in the search list takes us to a record with a summary that describes the author's views on limiting family size. Whether we agree with this author or not, this is a book that does talk about the global population and the conflicts that may arise over the future competition of natural resources, so this seems like it would be relevant. Throughout the semester, you may encounter sources that oppose your point of view, but I challenge you to consider using at least one or two sources this semester that give an opposing viewpoint. Similar to what we showed earlier, you can find this book by writing the call number down, looking at the status, and going to the location specified here. Many of you may be distant students, so accessing the printed books in the Eli M. Obler Library in Pocatello may be a challenge. We have several different options for you, and another video may talk about accessing our books through the mail or through our courier system to our campus library sites in Idaho Falls, Meridian, and Twin Falls. However, if you do not want to go through that process, or you do not have time to come to the library, then limit your results to electronic books or ebooks. In many cases, especially in the health sciences fields, the most current books are in the electronic format. Once you have conducted your search, you can use this drop-down menu, which shows different ways to limit your results by location or source type, including electronic resources. Use this limiter to find the available ebooks that include your search terms. In order to access the electronic books, select the link that says website. Once you do that, a new tab opens that links to the PDF full text that you can download and read. In other instances, it may look different, so when a new tab opens, You may be able to read the book right there on the screen or have to click on links to access particular chapters. For those of you going into the health sciences professions, looking at the Clinical Key database might be a good idea. This database provides access to scholarly articles and books. Back on the library website, there is a tab for databases along the top. In the drop-down menu, we can find Clinical Key. If we search for type 2 diabetes and diet, we see many results. With this week's assignment focus on finding books, we must limit to just the books on the left-hand side. In this case, we get 22 results. The first two results look quite relevant to help us find information about recommended diets for managing type 2 diabetes. When we click on this first result, the system takes us directly to the section that talks about diet therapy in managing diabetes. While this may not be a long section in the book, it can still be a useful source for providing basic background information. This section further down on nutritional supplements may also be of interest to those looking at diet as a therapy for people with diabetes. Some of the databases provide help with documenting sources, but not all of them do that. After deciding to use this as an assignment source, you will need to document this book in either APA or MLA style. For the pre-nursing students, we do want you to use the APA style. All this information can be found here in the database. You may need to scroll up to the beginning of the chapter to find the author information for this particular chapter. Here we can see the author, the textbook title, and the page numbers for this particular chapter. If we click on the book title, then we can see the chapter titles and more information about the book. For example, we can see the date of publication provided here. We can also look at the front matter of the book for more information. Be aware that when you document a chapter in a book, you need to provide the chapter title, author's name, date, book title, any editor's names, edition number, page numbers, and sometimes the publisher's name and place of publication. So that's why it is important to look at the front matter in the book. In this video, we have shown you how to find books in OneSearch, in the library catalog, and also in the Clinical Key database. We have also shown how to limit results by date and also by ebook format. If you decide to go and find a book in the physical library, do remember to write down the call number and the location before you go. Be sure to check availability, or you may not be able to find it on the shelf if someone else has it. If you need assistance finding a book, or you've never looked for a book in the library before, you may consider watching a YouTube video titled Finding Books in the Idaho State University Library. That shows how to find a book in the physical library using a call number. Of course, we have librarians and library student workers who can help you find books in the building as well, so please do not hesitate to ask us for help. My office is on the third floor of the Obler Library, and I would be glad to help any student locate books, since I think that's a fun thing to do. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please let us know, and we will do our best to answer them. Goodbye!